Last session I will be handling for projections of solids, wherein I have to cover two more portions. One is hexahedron, another is suspended solids, especially suspended pyramids. Now if I just come to this hexahedrons, so hexahedron, as you know, it is a polyhedra bounded by plane surfaces. But in the case of hexahedron, these plane surfaces, they are all squares, and we have six squares because, as the name indicates, it is the hexahedron. So hexahedron I can consider to be a polyhedra having six square faces bounded by one another. And we can also consider this hexahedron as a special case of square prism. So how do you say that a square prism can be considered as a hexahedron? Just think, you can just see that in the case of, if a square prism having a particular side, then if the length of the axis is also equal to the length of the side itself, then a square prism will become a hexahedron or a cube. Is it okay? Now let us consider the projections of hexahedron. So for the demonstration purpose, I am just taking a problem wherein we have a hexahedron, that is a cube of, let us say, 25 mm side, resting on one of its corners of its base on the ground, such that the solid diagonal is perpendicular to it. I will just repeat. In this particular case, we have an hexahedron resting on one of its corners of its base on the ground, then the solid diagonal is perpendicular to BP. Now as you can see, in this particular problem I have not given any inclination at all, because generally we used to do the problem whenever I give the axis inclinations, or I would have given one axis inclination and one side inclination. So in this particular case, I need to derive with the given data the axis inclination. Is it okay? Now if we just see, in this particular case the solid diagonal is perpendicular to VP. But first of all, I should know what is a solid diagonal. Now for that, I am just going to demonstrate with this a cube. So now we can just see that this is a cube having square faces, and it has got six square faces, they are bounded by one another. So now we need to distinguish between a solid diagonal and a face diagonal. So what is a face diagonal? It is nothing but, whenever you consider any face in this particular cube, if I consider the lines which are joining the topmost corner to the bottommost corner for that particular face, we can consider it to face diagonal. So obviously this particular cube, a particular face, has got two face diagonals. Now since it has got six faces, I can say it has got 12 face diagonals. So what is border diagonal, which can also be considered as a solid diagonal? The solid diagonal is one wherein, if I join, if you just see this particular cube, I am just going to join the topmost corner from this side to the bottommost corner on the opposite side, that is from the top base to the bottom base on the either sides or the opposite ends. So I will consider that to be a body diagonal or a solid diagonal. Is it okay? Now a cube has got how many border diagonals? I can say this is one border diagonal, then I consider these two, or can I consider these two. That means say that totally we have four body diagonals or four solid diagonals. Is it okay? Now in this particular problem, first I need to start. Now so how do you start? So obviously once I start doing, I can just make out which is that border diagonal, then I can keep on fulfilling the required condition given in the problem. Okay, now how do you start? Now in this particular problem, since I have given that it is resting on one of its corners on the ground, that is a corner should be in HP. Now since one of the corners should be on HP, we know that we need to, I need to consider this entire base containing that particular corner to be on X1N itself or on HB itself, so that I can see the true base will be seen in top view. So I need to start from top view. Okay, so how do you start the top view? Now it is given that the corner should rest on the ground. Now we know that when a corner rests on the ground, in the initial position, that corner containing the two adjacent sides should make equal inclination. That is, I need to keep in this way. Can you just make out? So if I say a corner is resting on the ground, then this particular corner containing these two sides should make equal inclinations. If you just recollect, if I say that a side is resting on the ground, I would have kept in this way, no? So if I just kept it in this way, then that particular side has to be kept perpendicular to VP. So thereby, if I lift it, so now we can see that if I just keep it in this way and if I lift it, it rests on a side. But anyway, in this figure, anyway, it is a symmetrical figure. I can lift in either way. But now I wanted this corner to be on the ground. Obviously, I need to keep in this particular way so that the corner containing the two sides, that is, I am just talking about the top. So these two sides should make equal inclination with reference to HP. So that's what I do in the first way. Okay. Now I need to identify this solid diagonal. So which is the solid diagonal here? Either I can say this one, or I can say this one, or I can say that one, or I can say the other. So totally we have four body diagonals. I am going to concentrate on one body diagonal, then I am going to fulfill. Okay, so let us do the problem, then I am going to demonstrate with this particular cube itself. Is it okay? Okay, now draw the XY line. Now as I said, I need to start from top view. That is, in the top view, I should draw the square. How do you draw the square? That orientation should be such that the corner containing the two sides should make equal inclinations. Is it okay? So let me draw the square. So I just drawn the square. Now I need to name them. So as usual, since I am starting from top view, I need to start naming from leftmost visible point in the anti-clockwise direction. Okay. So A, B, C, D. One base, I can say top base, and the other bottom base I can consider as A1, B1, C1, D1. Then I can also note on this axis. Okay, now I need to draw the corresponding front view. So where do you draw the front view? I will consider, since I wanted a corner to be on the ground, initially I will consider this entire base to be on the ground itself, that is on XY line itself. So let me do that. Then what is the height I should take? You know that the height should be equal to the base itself. So I will take the same height, then I will consider. So I will take an approximately same height, then complete this, then name them. So what about the naming now? Your top base should be ABCDs, bottom base should be A1, B1, C1, D1. So I will write this as A dash, B dash, C dash, D dash, then A1 dash, B1 dash, C1 dash, and D1 dash. Of course, axis will come here. Now I need to identify one body diagonal. Okay, so as I said, the body diagonal is a line joining the topmost corner of one end to the bottommost corner of the other end. So either I can take this or this. Okay, now let us say in this problem, I will consider this is my body diagonal. So this is my body diagonal joining from the topmost point of the base, that is corner A dash, with the bottommost other side, that is C1 dash. So I can say A dash C1 dash corresponding to a body diagonal. Now in this particular figure, where do you have the body diagonal here? So this is A dash. So A dash is comes A1. A is here itself. And C1 dash C1 is here itself. So that in the top view, your body diagonal is like this. Can you just make out? This is the body diagonal in the top view. This is the body diagonal in the front view. Okay, now this is my initial figure. So what about the next stage? Next stage, I need to see that it should rest on a corner on the ground. Okay, now as you can see, in this particular case, the body diagonal is inclined. Now, as I said, I will consider this body diagonal or this body diagonal. Okay, so that is, I will consider this also as a body diagonal now. So either I consider this or I consider this. Now, since if I want to lift in this way, just see this, if I want to lift in this way, I will consider this is the body diagonal. Let us say I want to lift it with A1 dash corner. Then I have to lift in this way. Is it okay? Now, in this particular case, I want to lift such that C1 dash should be on XY line. Now, since C1 is on the XY line, your body diagonal also will change. Now, what will happen to body diagonal? Anyway, I told you that the body diagonal is perpendicular to VP. Now, since the body diagonal is perpendicular to VP, with reference to HP, what about the body diagonal now? Since it is perpendicular to VP, it should be parallel to HP. That is the reason I am just going to lift it. I am going to lift with this corner so that this body diagonal A1 dash C dash will be parallel to HP. Are you following what I am telling? So that I am making this body diagonal parallel to HP because it should be perpendicular to VP. Is it okay? So in the next stage, I am going to lift this such that I am going to consider C1 dash on XY line. Yeah, now we can see I wanted this corner to be on the ground. I am considering the C1 dash should be on XY line. Then this body diagonal should be parallel to VP. So I am just going to lift in this way. So just to redraw this figure, what I have done is, it is a very simple thing. As you can see, this is the body diagonal and I am just considering this vertical line. I am just considering a line perpendicular to this line. So I am just concentrating on these two. So what I did here was, first I have drawn this particular line. Then I have taken this length and this length. Then I am going to complete this figure. Is it okay? Now as you can see, it is very easy to redraw the figure if you do it in a particular way. You can do it other way also. If you do it other way, it may take more time. But anyway, you need to do at a faster pace so that I hope this is the simplest method. Okay. Now I have just drawn this second stage such that it is the base, this particular cube resting on one of its corners on the ground, then the body diagonal is parallel to VP, parallel to HP. Now I need to draw the corresponding new top view. So how do you draw the new top view? As usual, I need to draw the projectors. That is, draw the vertical projectors from the new front view and horizontal projectors from the previous top view. I just drawn this, then get the points now. Okay, let us say I first want to get this A, B, C, D, then this will be A1, B1, C1, D1. I just got the points. How do you complete this figure? Same procedure. What is the procedure? That is, this figure will depending upon how we are going to orient in your front view. So reference figure is front view. Now in the front view, this is XY line, that is the plane, object, observer. Is it okay? Now observer, since it is a case of a prism only now, because it is a special case of prism. Now we just remember, the first step in this particular case to complete this figure is, I need to look for the base which is nearer to the observer. Now for this observer, which base is nearer to him? ABCD. So first complete ABCD. So I will just complete this A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E. Okay, base. What are the next step I take? Boundaries. So just draw this
one boundary DD1. Of course, DD1 I can see a longer edge or one of the face edges. So I just completed the boundaries.
Then I need to look for the other longer edges in this case. I can say either I can say longer edges or I can say simply face edges. So here the face edges are this BB and DD already taken care of. Okay, now I need to look for the other base. So what about the other base here? Anyway, as you can see ABCD base. So obviously I cannot say this A1, B1, C1, D1 completely. Okay, so already A1, B1 is there. Now what about B1, C1? Now I told you the procedure, now already you have one solid line. So this particular line has to be dotted because one behind the other, now. So obviously this has to be dotted line.
Similar analogy, this also should be dotted line.
Is it okay? Now what about this CC? For the observer, CC is farthest. Not only that, this is an invisible point. This is a visible point. What about the resulting line? It has to be invisible. So this is also invisible. Now what about AA? For the observer, AA is the nearest to him. So not only that, this is visible point, this is visible point, this has to be seen completely. Okay, then I can show the axis. So what about the axis here? So it will come somewhere here itself. Okay, now body diagonal. Now see this body diagonal here. A1, C1. Now as you can see in the second stage, the body diagonal AC is parallel to both HP as well as VP. Is it okay? But what I wanted this body diagonal A1C should be perpendicular to VP. Now as you can see in the second stage, the body diagonal A1C is parallel to both HP as well as VP. But now I need to fulfill this body diagonal to be perpendicular to VP. So what do you do then? So this is A1C, no? Now I want this A1C1 to be perpendicular. That means say that I need to redraw this figure such that I need to get this A1C perpendicular to XY line or perpendicular to VP. Okay, now as I told you, we need to redraw this top view such that A1C border diagonal will also should become perpendicular to VP. So I just redrawn this figure. Okay, so redraw the figure such that I am going to get this figure. Now once you redraw this figure, the new front view will be different now. So how do you get your new front view? New front view can be projected by drawing projectors from the new top view and draw horizontal projectors from the previous front view. So let me draw that. So draw these projectors. Okay, just draw the projectors. Then get the points as usual. Okay, we have A1. So A1 is here. So I will get A1, A1 dash of course, then B1 dash, then this will be C1 dash and this will be D1 dash. Similarly, let me get the points for the other base, A, then B dash, then I will get C dash here only, then this will be D dash. I got the points. Now I need to complete this. So what is the procedure to complete this? Because anyway, if you just see this, I cannot complete it. So it is very difficult to imagine, no? So no need to imagine. Just you have to follow the procedure. So what is the procedure? As I said, this is XY line. This is the object I need to view in this way. Is it okay? Now for the observer, which base is nearer to the observer now? We have ABCD and A1, B1, C1, D1. So which one is nearer to the observer? A1, B1, C1 here. So first complete that base. So that is A1, B1, then B1, C1, C1, D1, and D1 back to A1. Then as usual boundaries. Boundaries.
has drawn the boundaries.
Then as you can see, this particular edge is nearer to the observer.
Yeah, yeah, but anyway, it is a solid point, na? So this is also a visible point. So just get like this.
Then other base. What about the other base? Other base is A, B, C, D. So now just see this.
A to B, then B to C. So B to C I cannot see. So dotted. Then C to D, I cannot see. Dotted. Then of course, this particular CC, for the observer, CC is farthest. Because anyway, this CC is invisible. Na? C dash is invisible. C1 is visible, but the result line has to be dotted.
So can you just make out this? Now we can see that your body diagonal or solid diagonal. So what is happening to your body diagonal in this case? Now as you can see in the final state, the body diagonal here, it is perpendicular to VP. That is A1C, but here it is seen as a point. Because still, what do we see as a point? It is parallel to HP. Is it okay? Now we can see that we have just covered this in three stages so that we satisfied that the particular cube is resting on one of its corners of its base on the ground such that the body diagonal is perpendicular to VP. Since it is perpendicular to VP, it will be seen as a point in the final front view, that is A1 dash C dash. Actually, this particular projection has got a very important conclusion. Whenever, I think, when you go to the next chapter, that is isometric projections. Because if you just see this particular view, if you see this particular view, all the square faces, what are the square faces? I can see this is one square face, we have this square face, then we have this square face. If you see all the square faces, all the square faces are equally foreshortened. Since they are equally foreshortened, they are all seems to be all parallelograms. Okay. And in fact, this particular cube can be visualized as a three-dimensional figure. Wherein I can see this cube, but only difference is all your squares has become equal rhombuses. I think this particular concept will be again. We are going to write this figure, then we are going to explain how to draw the projections in using isometric projections. As I told you, I can just demonstrate this particular problem using this particular cube. Okay, now what I did there, this is the initial position of the region. Then what I did there, I just lifted in this way now. So I am going to lift it in this way. Just see this. I am going to lift in this way, so that once I lift in this way, your body diagonal will be, so maybe I think I will hold in this way, you can just see this. This is how I have lifted, then this is the body diagonal. Now that particular body diagonal is parallel to VP. Now what I did in the finally, but anyway, this body diagonal has to be perpendicular to VP. Now see, you can see parallel to VP, if I just hold it in this way. That means that I am just going to rotate like this. Just see this. If I am just going to rotate like this, this body diagonal has become perpendicular to VP. But since it is perpendicular to VP, it will be parallel. So this is what I have written. Just see this. This is what I have written. So in this particular sketch, I can see for the observer, all these faces will be equal rhombuses. That is, all the lines are equally foreshortened. Since they are equally foreshortened, we consider those lines are iso lines. That is the reason that isometric projection has come into picture. Okay, thank you.